Welcome back to a quick episode of What If. This is episode 4, and today, thanks to a user of mine named Token Black as Pie, weird usernames, but thanks for watching. He commented on an idea he would want me to do for the next What If, and he gave me a good idea, which was, what if Fall Out Boy fans, or really the whole world at large, had supported and or enjoyed Patrick Stump's soul punk album? So today, I think I'm just going to title this one, What If Patrick Stump's Solo Career Took Off During Fall Out Boy's Hiatus, and They Never Got Back Together. So, yeah, let's just look at some background to how soul punk became to be. So in November of 2009, Fall Out Boy themselves decided to take a hiatus, but it wasn't just any regular hiatus, it was an indefinite hiatus. So this meant that they could come back soon, or they might not come back ever, which meant, you know, a lot of disappointed fans. But that meant that everybody in the band was going to do their own thing. Andy Hurley and Joe Troman, they joined the metal band The Damn Things with members from Anthrax, and another band I can't remember the name, but that's what it was. They released an album in 2010, so they were still doing music. And Pete Wentz himself did a lot of producing for music, while also delving more into the acting stuff. He had done acting beforehand, but did a little bit more of it during his time away from Fall Out Boy, which left Patrick Stump. Now, a lot of people did say, that he was definitely going to go solo. They didn't know what direction he was going to take it in, and what to expect, and when to expect a solo album from Patrick Stump. Now, he originally said the album was finished in 2010, but he ended up not really liking the finished product, so he decided to pretty much start over from scratch. Not really scrap the album, but just rewrite some of the songs, redo some of the songs, and put them on the album itself. And he ended up not releasing an album first. He actually released an EP on February 22nd of 2011 called The Turrent Wave. It featured 6 songs, it was a little bit over 24 minutes, and it actually peaked at number 67 on the Billboard 200. So not fantastic, but it peaked on the Billboard. It didn't feature any singles, and it had a couple of features on this album, or on this EP, I should say. The only 2 songs that didn't have features were Spotlight, Oh Nostalgia, and Love, Selfish Love, and As Long As I Know I'm Getting Paid. Porcelain featured Alphabet, Cute Girls featuring Omis Keith, and Big Hype featuring D.A. Chester French, which is a indie pop artist that's no longer around, and Dreas, which is Idris Elba's musician name. So he worked with Idris Elba. Now, Spotlight, Oh Nostalgia might sound familiar, and I'll get to that in a minute. But it wasn't until October 18th of 2011 that Patrick Stump released his solo album, Soul Punk. It has 2 singles, which was This City, the remixed version with Lupe Fiasco. There's also just a regular version that doesn't feature Fiasco on the album. And a song called Spotlight, New Regrets, which was kind of the sequel to Spotlight, Oh Nostalgia. He released both of those at the same time, but, he decided to release them not on the same album. He ended up actually performing some of his songs on TV, like on Good Morning New Orleans and The Tonight Show, which isn't around anymore, doesn't look like, and The Tonight Show with Jay Leno, along with Hoppus on Music back when he had that show on Fuse. So people were recognizing that he was becoming a solo artist. And if you're wondering, Soul Punk, the regular version's 11 songs, 46 minutes, and there's a deluxe edition with 15 songs, 62 minutes, or If you live in Japan, the Japanese deluxe edition had 16 songs and was a little bit over 65 minutes. The album did actually peak at number 47 on the Billboard 200 in its first week, but then sales started to fall off despite it getting pretty critical reception, really good reception, and just good promotion, decent promotion after all. And the album itself was more pop, soul, R&B, and synth pop influenced, and of course, Patrick Stump states that it was heavily influenced by Michael Jackson, as most of the comparisons came out to be. And even though the album sales started tailing off, he did get to open for Bruno Mars and Janelle Monáe, along with playing a Chicago and Japanese music festival where he supported Panic at the Disco. So, you know, there was a lot going on, as this is just a weird case of the album sold well in its first week because it was highly anticipated. You know, whether you were a Fall Out Boy fan or not, you know, you just kind of were anxious and wanted to see what Patrick Stump was going to do in this situation. And, you know, I think that that the album doesn't get enough recognition for it, what it is, and I think it should have more than just the two singles that I mentioned, because there are other good songs on here. Explode's one of my favorite, Dance Miserable, The Eye and Lie, Everybody Wants Somebody is very good, and Coast, It's Gonna Get Better, but, you know, I guess people just kind of heard it, and real Fall Out Boy fans are pissed off about it because it sounded nothing like what Fall Out Boy would do, and I guess other fans were just like, eh, I don't really care that much now. But to me, I think it was just too ahead of its time for becoming popular. Like, if he released this thing now, I can bet you that that thing would be in the top 10 tomorrow, but I think he just released it too early, which led to declining sales. But now we're going to take a look at, what if this album actually did successful? What would the future of Fall Out Boy and Patrick Stump look like? So as I stated before, both his EP and his album peaked on the Billboard 200, number 67 for the EP and number 47 for the album. But what if the album took off for Patrick Stump during the hiatus right here? And what would happen to his future, and what would happen to Fall Out Boy? And my answer would be, this would probably be the first time where I would say, I don't think Fall Out Boy would have ever gotten back together. I mean, It was one of those things where it was an indefinite hiatus, so if there was other things that the bandmates wanted to do, and I had a feeling if one of them, especially Patrick Stump and Pete Wentz, became very popular at doing something, I don't think they were even going to think about going back to Fall Out Boy. And they were kind of saying they were running out of ideas for Fall Out Boy, and, you know, who knows? We would never have those three albums that they've had out since their hiatus. But I definitely think Patrick would have taken this thing solo a lot more, and around this time he could have had two or three more albums out around this point, and could have just been his own big thing. Because, I mean, he was in a band where the bassist was basically more popular than the vocalist. Don't get me wrong, though, Patrick Stump was one of the more, you know, popular in the band, but it was all Pete Wentz this and Pete Wentz that, and I think had this album would have taken off and he would have seen the recognition he was getting, he would just finally be like, you know, I won't have anybody who's ahead of me. I just think that he would have had more fun with it. And yeah, I don't think Fall Out Boy, would have never came back, which means not only would we have been down Fall Out Boy, but we would have also been down MCR, which having one of them is gone is hard enough. Having both of them gone, Jesus Christ, that would have sucked. But anyway, so yeah, that's basically my take on this thing. There's not a lot of, like, research other than what I said, because, like, the Paramore thing, if Hayley Williams had gone solo, or if Paramore had broken up in 2011, it was more just my opinion, and I think that's what this is. So, yeah, Patrick Stump, definitely would have kept going. So that does it for What If Episode 4. Tell me in the comments below, what do you guys think would have happened had soul punk risen to the top for Patrick Stump? And do you think Fall Out Boy would still be around if the album just took off? And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. I'm thinking of more ideas for this series since you guys like it so much, since I like doing it so much. And, you know, but to help me out, since I'm still thinking of ideas, like the username I mentioned, I don't remember the name now, gave me an idea, and I went with it because it was a good idea. So, yeah. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed. Please remember to like and subscribe, if you're on Facebook, share, and I'll catch you guys next time.